Thank you for tuning in to another edition of the Vulcan Report. This report is for Friday, April the 8th, 2016. This is a live intraday chart of the U.S. dollar futures contract. The week has been extremely choppy and pretty much insane price action all across the board in many markets, which we'll get to in a second. I wanted to show you, though, the weakening extended process of the U.S. dollar. And over time, throughout the week, the market tried to retrace a little bit, only to collapse and take out the prior week's low. And as you can see now, we're trading at 94.26. If we accelerate the selling into the close today, that's going to put us right here toward the bottom half of this Kumo cloud. A close below this Kumo cloud, it will set up a strengthening process for this decline, and we could quickly get back into the long-term support zone of 88. So that would be a heck of a move, but that is what is in the cards right now as the euro continues to strengthen. The U.S. dollar is in a powerful downtrend and the euro is in a powerful uptrend. As long as the euro can close above the 114 handle today, that 114 should show and prove to be strong support moving forward as the euro makes its way to 115 up toward the 120-122 price range. All right, taking a look now at the metals. Let's see here. Let's take a look at gold first. All right, so taking a look at the gold chart here. As you can see, the market's powering up now here for the weekly, trying to get a push above the 1244 handle. A close above the 1244 handle will put and set the stage for higher prices into next week, moving closer to that 1300 initial target that we spoke about earlier. Right now, the market has very strong support at 1179.20. And you can see the momentum is starting to turn up. Taking a look at the silver chart now, which has been lagging the gold this week. It's been showing itself to be a lot weaker. Well, as you can see now, it's finally trying to power up here. As we get longer in the day, we're at 1537 now. Market's trying to get a push deeper into the bottom of the Kumo cloud. A close at the bottom of the Kumo cloud could set us up to retest the prior close of 1589. If the market can get up there and close above 1589, that will set the stage for prices to break into back into the 1622 price range and hit our initial target of 17. We'll give it until next week. The way the silver's been moving, though, it could take a little bit longer than that, but that's what it's looking for right now. We have strong support at 1444 right now in the silver market. Okay, now taking a look at the crude oil market, which is the real talk of the town, we have strong support at 2852. Market's trying to power up, momentum's turning up, but we're still in a well-defined downtrend here. All the market managed to do was get a close above the short-term moving average right here, trading right now. And I would say that it's trying to retest and get back up toward the long-term trend line, that $44, $45 price range. We fell before, and I just see more of the same. I think the market's setting up to head lower. We'll have to wait and see how we finish out for the day. But even though it's at $39 now, $40 seems to be a very strong ceiling for this market. The last time we've been up here, the market managed to close at 41.17 3 weeks ago, and immediately crashed since then and has come all the way down to 35.25. So that's quite a collapse in price. We'll have to wait and see what it, you know, how we turn from there. But just wanted to let you know that this, even though we're above here, we broke out of, above the weekly resistance of 36.32. Market is strong going into the day here as we get close near the close for Friday. That still does not necessarily mean that this market is going to get into the bottom of this Kumo cloud. I'm still very doubtful about that. I think that all these rallies are going to continue to be sold like we did here last time. So we'll just have to wait and see. And this last time here didn't really get above it like we're doing now, but still it was sold. Rallies tend to be sold heavily in this crude oil market. It's going to take a lot to turn that horse around. All right, let's take a look now at equities. Strong word of caution here in the equities. I truly believe that the equities are setting up for a major, major crash. Momentum is starting to turn down here, but look at this. We fell from here, came here, V-shaped recovery, which is rare. Almost, you could say it's like a double top here. Trend line is still down. And I think we're going to crack below the short-term trend line support of 1075 in the E-mini. I'm sorry, in the Russell 1075. And once we close below that, I think this market will accelerate and crash below the 995.50 weekly support. And below that, the next support won't be until like 880 or 888, somewhere around there. So I believe the equities are in trouble, and I see that happening on a global scale. The algorithms are screaming right now, and I see a lot of pressure behind the scenes. There's been a little bit of weird price action too when you get into the market depth. When you look at the put-call ratios, a lot of weirdness is happening right now, and something doesn't feel right. From a technical perspective, I see the market going down, but there's something else nefarious going on behind the scenes. I can't quite put my finger on it, but this is starting to feel a lot like 2008. That's the only thing I have to compare it with. So definitely be careful. And if you're trading the long side temporarily, keep your stops tight and take quick profits, and always be prepared to go short. I see all rallies in the equity markets getting ready to get pounded, and I mean hard and fast. So just wanted to point that out for you. Here's the E-mini S&P 500. You just saw the Russell. Here's the E-mini S&P 500. Notice how the Russell is leading. Right now, the S&P 500 managed to get above the Kumo cloud here and above the trend lines. Instead of a cross upward, I see a situation happening where it like kind of touches it rising and then turns down. Momentum down. You have a divergence. Price going up, indicator going down. Weekly support on the S&P right now is at 1889, and I have to tell you, I see an acceleration coming based on the nefarious things I've been seeing in the market. This is not normal. If price action was normal and all things being equal, I would say, oh, you know, it's a bull market. The market's trying to become a bull market. But no, I think what it's doing is it's actually putting in a head and shoulders situation. We're getting a failed top here. Again, the last top back on November, the week of November the 2nd of 2015, we topped out And those rallies, every rally got sold. Here, we got sold. Here, we got sold. Here, we got sold. Here, we got sold. Now it's in a long extension, and I think we're about to get sold. All right, so again, nice recovery here, but this was stimulus, or should I say verbal stimulus. The reason the market tried to rally this morning was because people got really happy when they saw the world's greatest cheerleaders the stock market has ever known all together on one stage in a panel discussion. You had Yellen, you had Bernanke, you had Greenspan, and Volcker with the famous Volcker rule nonsense. Here you are, you have all these talking head cheerleaders of the past talking and cheerleading and propping up the market, trying to kick the can down the road a little bit further, trying to prevent it. Since the 90s, when have you ever known a panel discussion like that with all the former Federal Reserve chairs speaking and cheerleading the markets? You've never seen that before. That means that they are very, very, very fearful, very afraid. They're frightened to death that these global markets are about to absolutely give up the ghost. That means what you're seeing, all of this right here, is fake. It's fluff. And I think the most powerful collapse correction that you've ever seen is in the works. And that's just how it is. The markets are in trouble. The economy is in trouble. No matter what they say, you can believe the opposite. The president says anyone talking bad about the economy is peddling fiction. That's what he said, peddling fiction. Well, I'm here to tell you that you're about to see the results of peddling fiction. So remember, bulls make money, bears make money, but pigs get slaughtered. Take what you can, give nothing back, and keep shorting. Get ready to short this market like you've never shorted it before. Have a great weekend. Thank you for tuning in to another edition of the Volcker Report. This report is for trading on Wednesday, April the 6th, 2016. What you're looking at now is a live chart of the U.S. dollar index futures contract. As you can see on the intraday time frame here, the market has basically managed to break out above the 95 handle. If you recall from the earlier video, the market did manage to break out from the 94.77 intraday resistance, and now the market has popped up and trying to make a run here into new highs. Market is showing that it's trying to lock in this trend as well early on. Getting a better view of where we're looking at heading is above the trend line resistance here at 95.03. So far we've hit 95.07, and the market is desperately trying to close above this 95.03 trend line resistance. If the market can manage to do that, then it should be able to push its way up toward the higher end of the Kumo cloud here, getting closer to the 96 handle. The top of the range now is at 95.50. So if the market can push up to the 95.50, preferably by the end of today, that will set the market up for a nice rebound, getting back up toward 98, possibly as early as Friday, depending on what kind of momentum we get from the euro. Giving you a better picture of what that looks like. In the overnight session, the euro did manage to pull back further As you can see here, we dropped from this 113.96 support down to 113.49. It's now touching the trend line support here at 113.46. A close below that would set the stage for lower prices dropping below the bottom of the Kumo cloud at 112.82. And that would set the stage for further declines going back down toward the 111 handle. Overhead resistance right now is at 114.30. A break above 114.30 would put an end to the downward correction and set this market up for higher prices going headed back up to 115.116. Moving along now, taking a look at the E-mini S&P 500. Overnight, the market has managed to put in a low of 20.40.5 and a high of 20.49.5. Very tight trading range. Overhead resistance is at 20.56.5. And the bottom of the Kumo cloud here is around the 20.38 handle, which we are just about 4 points away from. So 38 is showing to be a nice solid support, as you can see here with these three bars here. So if the market can manage to get above the 20.56.5, it would put an end to the corrective downtrend and set the market up to retest the 20.69 upper end of its resistance range. And then that would help push the market back above the 2100 all-time highs level. So we'll have to watch to see what happens here in the mini S&P. Moving right along now to the crude oil market. Overnight, crude oil managed to strengthen somewhat. As you can see here, we popped above the slower term moving average resistance trend line here, and now it's kind of just waffling around. Overhead resistance would be the longer term moving average trend line at 37.60, and prices breaking below 35.70 would set us up for another leg down, which could be quite substantial. So the market would see shorts jump in at this 35.7, a break below 35.70 on this crude oil. So that's something that is definitely going to be watched to see what happens there. And let's see, let's take a look at the gold market. Gold right now is down. 12.18.40 right now is in effect. A break below 12.18.40 would set this market up for another leg down, testing the 1200 support, which you don't want to see. If you're bullish, if you're long this market, you want to see this market maintain and continue to close above this 12.18.40. Right now it's looking like it wants to test that. Here we had a successful test of trend line support. Market broke higher, but then finally gave it up. And we hit, put in a new low, moved sideways. Had a breakout here when we broke above the 12.29.20 overhead resistance. Got as high as 12.39.20. Nice $10 run. And now here we are pulling back here within the range. So we're forming a nice little triangle flag here, and a breakout above it would set us up for a run to the 1240 level, which is the upper outside of this Kumo cloud. And as you can see, as we're talking, the market is coming down. We're now at 1222.40. Alright, taking a look at the silver. Alright, silver in the overnight market. As you can see, right now, 1477 is strong support. A break below 1477 would cause this market to fall rather hard, and we will be looking at getting into the 13 handle as early as possibly the end of the day, or at least by the close on Friday, which is not a good sign for the bullish argument, because up here we were looking at being hopeful of breaking out above the Kumo cloud before this happened, and now here we are. Looks like the market wants to test those lows, so that's problematic right now if you are along this market. There's also a lot of price action or stops in or around the 1994 handle. 1994 is the magic trend line within this market that you don't see here. Okay, a break below that would set us up to test this 1477 rather quickly. So that's where we are on that one. So that's where most longs have their stops at. And if those stops, that 1494 is taken out, most of the longs would reverse and get short at a break below this 1477, because you're looking at least a dollar run to the downside if that happens in the silver. And if you're bullish metals, you don't want to see that, but here we are on the daily chart at risk of breaking below this Kumo cloud. And the bottom of the Kumo cloud on a daily chart is at 1480. So the 77 price that I gave you is outside the Kumo cloud, below the Kumo cloud, which is mad bearish. All right. And then you come over here, pull up a longer term weekly chart showing you what? Strong support at 1444. So on the intraday level, we take out that 77. It's going to be a pylon to help the market get to this 1444, and a break below the 1444 in the weekly is done. That's one and done. That puts you, it renews the bearish position, takes out the failed bull run up here. This becomes nothing more than a correction to the trend line to get shorts on board at that point, and that would be disastrous for the bull argument. And last but not least, let's take a look at this soybean. Soybeans is nice because when it finally starts to move, it moves like the S&P 500. You got strong support right now at 863.5. You don't want to see prices take that out. If it does, then this sets up the next leg down, which could be massive as well. Right now, the market's in a bullish upward pattern. Trading at the, trying to take out that 921.5 upper overhead resistance. Market's been bumping its head at it, trying to test it. So it's going to try its best to power up and get above this trend line. A good close above this trend line resistance at 921.5 sets the market up lovely for next week to get inside the Kumo cloud and make a test to get outside of the Kumo cloud. That's going to put this over at the 1,000 mark, as you can see right here. That would be incredible. So $10 beans would be amazing. That's a huge run from where we are now. But when beans get really moving and getting powerful trends, it can move. As you can see here, well, we had this bar here where it went from 1527 to 1250. All right, I've seen even worse than that. So beans can move. So that's not out of the question, even though we've been quiet for a while here for several weeks. It can still make a run for it. So we'll just keep on watching, see what happens. And remember, bulls make money, bears make money, but pigs get slaughtered. So remember, take what you can, give nothing back.